All right, man, I want y'all to go check out my boy Dame J, new album, No Regrets. And I'm telling you, this brother got 10 straight bangers on here. Not a filler song. Upper echelon engineering, production. And obviously, he got the bars. Definitely a banging album right here. You don't want to miss out on this. One of the best underground albums I heard. So go check out his new album as soon as possible. I put the Apple and Tidal links in the description, but it's on all streaming platforms. Go check out my boy Dame J. You won't be disappointed. Peace. All right, man. Young Buck is out of jail. He had been in jail since December on a felony fugitive justice warrant. I don't know what the hell that is, but I know it was said that he had abandoned a minor somewhere in, I think, Georgia or something like that. But let's talk about it. Hit that subscribe button, bell icon button, share the video. Check our music entertainment playlist out for more videos like this. And he's trying to sever ties with 50 Cent by filing bankruptcy and trying to emancipate himself from that record deal, that it got to be a slave deal. And one of the things that's sad about it is 50 could just let him go. You know what I'm saying? And he can just do his own thing. He was dropping music and 50 was having the record label take it down. That's one thing I say, man. You know, you expect the other to do that to a brother. You know what I'm saying? But you don't expect another brother to try to choke you out and treat you like a slave. And I think that's what hurts the most about this whole situation is 50 could just let him go. But he refusing to let him go, but Buck posted this: emancipation, the fact of process of being set free from legal, social, or political restrictions, liberation. Now let's get to it. So he must have found a legal loophole to get away from 50 Cent by filing bankruptcy. It was said that, but you know, for like, I think between 2017 and 19, they were saying that he had made at least $100,000 per year due that time. So, you know, he back, he out. 50 Cent still been jabbing him while he been in jail, and you know, just, you know, trying to humiliate Buck and people just going along with it. But all these people, you know, they see what's going on to Ahmaud Arbery, and then there was another young lady who was killed by the police in Kentucky, and they had the wrong search warrant. All this shit going on, but they don't see that a brother man treating another brother man wrong, where he can't feed his family and choking them out. When 50 making money 10,000 different ways, he could just end the beef and let, you know, Young Buck go and finish his career. And that's how I look at it. Just another brother holding another brother down. Like I said before, 50 Cent make amazing music. You know, I was just listening to the Rider music in the car. Amazing song. But, you know, when he tried to talk about Oprah tearing down black men, him and Oprah are responsible for tearing down damn near the same amount of black people, especially men, especially 50. You know what I'm saying? When he can just let Young Buck spread his wings. That's why Lloyd Banks just rapped about his ass and let him know. He only want to tell one side of the story. He want to come out looking good, but Curtis just miserable. You know, his son don't love him. You know, none of his sons probably love him. None of his baby mamas love him. His girlfriend don't love him. She with him because he got money. And when you in that position and you financially, you know, free and fluid and you can do whatever you want to do, it's hard to find people that love you just for you. And as a man, it's hard to find love from women and children, because if you don't provide the back and you don't do what they say do, they not trying to understand why you don't have the time to spend with them, or why you missed a karate match, or missed a basketball game because you got to provide. You know what I'm saying? Only time a man really get that love like that, man, is, you know, once you provide money or once you die. You know what I'm saying? That's who get the most love on Father's Day. It's the fathers that's dead, and they ain't never got that much love, you know, in a long time from their family. And it's just a sad truth. But with 50, you know, I just think he taking some of his life situations and frustrations out on Buck, Banks, and the rest of them. But maybe he truly feel like he gave them the keys to success and they didn't listen. You know, I know he was telling Buck that he had to take taxes out of his money, and I guess Buck didn't listen, and that's why he in the situation that he is in. But, you know, Young Buck gonna continue to keep his foot on his neck. At one point, this might have to get down to a physical altercation. But you don't want to get to that point, because, you know, you're going to end up going to jail regardless. You're going to be back where you just left. But if you can't feed your family and financially you can't do nothing else, you know, what happened when, you know, like Tupac said, when, you know, you starve out the homeless, or you starve out people that's hungry, eventually, you know, we will overcome. We'll turn into, we taking that shit, we breaking in, we looting, we riding. We coming through, and Young Buck might be at the point, especially with this coronavirus going on, he may be at the point where he ready to take his shit back. So if this bankruptcy emancipation process don't work for Buck, I don't know what else he gonna do. You know what I'm saying? I don't know if he gonna try to get a movie deal, be a ghostwriter, but still, his contract, them music contracts are so thorough that it's probably restricted for him getting credited for ghostwriting. He probably don't even own the name Young Buck. He might have to do some worse day and time shit and switch his name. You know what I'm saying? He probably don't even own his name with 50 Cent. And it's sad. It's sad to see another brother starve another brother out, no matter what you've been through. One thing I can say about T Grizzly, he let Sada Baby free. You know, he ain't try to hold no shit over him. He said, hey, bro, you want to be free? Be free. And he let Sada Baby do what he gonna do. That's what real niggas do, you know? And 50 Cent just want to have power over people, man. And to somebody make an example out of that nigga, man, you know, Young Buck still gonna be in the position he is. So Buck trying to fight on a white collar level. You know what I'm saying? Buck ain't he tired of fighting on the blue collar level and making raps and diss and 50 taking them down and doing this, that, and the third. If this white collar level shit don't work up, you know, he told me he gripping his pistol at the grocery store when somebody pressed him. He gonna have to grip that pistol and put it to Curtis Dome to get out this record deal. He gonna do some Suge Knight shit. But hey, let me know what you guys think. Don't forget me on Facebook, Instagram, Twitter. Appreciate everybody for tapping in. You know, want to make a donation, Cash App, PayPal in the description. All my social media links in the description. Let me know what you think about the situation. I put the article link in the description. One time for the one time. Welcome home to Young Buck, Goodfellas Sports TV. Appreciate you guys. And, you know, just let me know what you guys think about the video. One time for the one time. We gone.